Hello guys, how are you? So welcome to my channel IG Tech Team. Now in this video I will explain how can you connect your Python with MySQL database. So guys, without any delay, let's start. Before you start to write code, you must have Jamf installed in your system. So you can first visit to this site. I will paste this link in the description below. And then you can click on download 64-bit if you want to download Jamf in Windows. And if you want to install it in Linux and other operating system, you are also welcome to this site. Before you start to write code, you must install one model or package. So first you open command prompt. And then type here pip install mysql-connector. So pip install mysql connector and press enter. After installing this package, you can simply import it by writing import mysql.connector and then press shift enter. Okay, and then you can open your Jamf. You can source your Jamf from here, or you can simply go to local dixi, then you can find your Jamf here, and then you can simply start Jamf control, and then you have to start Apache and MySQL, and then you have to minimize Jamf. Now I will connect my Python to database, so I can simply write my db equals to mysql.connector.connect, and inside parenthesis you have to pass host name, user and password. So host equals to localhost, and then user equals to root, this is initial user, and then initially you have password equals to mpt. So password equals to mpt. If I want to check if my connection is established or not, I can simply write print my db and press shift enter. Okay, my connection is successfully established. Now I will create one database. I can simply write my cursor equals to my db.cursor. And now I can simply write my cursor.execute. Now I have to write SQL command here. So I can simply write create database, suppose students. And then I will press shift enter. Now if I want to see my database, so I can simply write my cursor ursor cursor.execute show database base, and then I will simply write for yux in my cursor I will print yux. So if I press shift enter, you can see here my students database is successfully created. You can also see this by visit to localhost/phpmyadmin. So I can simply write localhost/phpmyadmin. You can see here my students database is successfully created. If you want to delete your database, you can simply write my cursor.execute. You can simply write drop database and one database name, suppose this test. I can simply write test, and then I will press shift enter. Now if I again click on here, press enter, you can simply here test will be removed. Now I will create one table inside this student database. So I will simply copy this line of code, Control C, and then I will paste here, Control V, and then I will use, or I will pass database here, database, I will pass students here because I want to create table in this database. And then again I will simply write my cursor URSOR cursor equals to my db.cursor, and then my cursor dot execute execute. I will create one table here, create table, and table name suppose stu table, and then suppose I have id and the type of id is int. I will increment id automatically, so I will simply write auto increment, and I will assign id as primary key, so I will simply write primary key means unique key. Each student has unique id, and then I will write name here, and the type of name is varchar. I will assign length of name suppose 50, and then I will write suppose age, and the type of age is integer int. Now I will execute this code, so shift enter. Okay, I have one error here. I have to write comma over here, so I will write comma and then I will again press shift enter. Okay, now my execution is completed. Now if you want to see my table, so I can simply write my cursor dot execute, and I can simply write show tables for x in my cursor. I can simply print x. So my student table is successfully created. You can simply see this student table by visiting on this site. So if you press on students database, so your stu table is successfully created. If you press on this table, you can see here you have id, name and age, and there is no any record now. So I will simply insert one record. So I will simply write sql equals to insert into my table name stu table. I have id, name and age, and then I will pass values here. Values, I have two value, yes, percentage yes, percentage yes, and percentage yes. Sorry, I have three values, so I have to write 3% yes sign. And now I have to write value val equals to suppose id 1, name issue, and age 23. Now I will pass this SQL and val inside my cursor.execute. So I will write my cursor.execute. I will pass SQL and val here. Now I will write my db.commit, and I will print one message here, print my cursor.rowCount. Row count, and then record inserted. So what is this? If I press shift enter, you can see here one record inserted. So it returns the number of data or number of row inserted in our table. So I have one record inserted in my table, and you can see here. I will refresh this page. So id 1, name issued, and age 23. So my first record is inserted. Now I will back to my Jupyter notebook page. I can also insert multiple record at once. So I will copy this all code, Ctrl C and then Ctrl V. Now I will pass two data here. So I will simply write id as 2. And name is suppose Vijay, and age is 25, okay? And then I will insert another record. Suppose ID is 3, name is Ajay, and age is 20. So I have to write this data inside square bracket. So I will simply write square bracket here. And then I have to write execute many here. Execute many. So now if I press shift enter, two record inserted. I can see from here. So I will refresh this page. So you can see here my data has been successfully inserted. You can also see your data in this page also. So I can simply write my cursor here. So our cursor dot execute, and I can simply write select asterisk from my table name, stu table, and then I can simply write my result equals to my cursor. Yes, so our cursor dot fetch all. So I can simply write this method, and then I have to print my result. So for yux in my result, previous ULT result, I will print this x. So this is my data. So I can simply see my data in this page also. And one thing guys, I have explained about TK Inter in this video. So this is the code I have explained in that video. So if I execute this code, so I will press shift enter and then again shift enter, I will get this form. Now I will fill this all data and I will connect this form to database. I will store my data in this page again, in this page. So if you want to learn how can you make this form, you can simply watch my TK Inter video. You can find my TK Inter video in Python tutorial playlist or machine learning in data science playlist. Now I will copy that code. So I will press Ctrl C and then I will paste here. Ctrl V. And also I will copy all this code, Ctrl C, Ctrl A and Ctrl C and Ctrl V. Now I will press shift enter. So I will fill this table, and if I press submit button, my all data will be stored in database. So I will close this. You have to watch my TK Inter video first and then again come back to this video. So I will make some changes here. First of all, I will make one database. So I will again execute this code. I will change students by suppose Python database. This is one database name and I will press shift enter. Now I will again press shift enter. So you can see here my Python database is successfully created. Now I will create one table. I will pass database name as Python database. So Python database, BAS data Python database. Now I will make one table here. So I will give this name to my table. So I will minimize this and then I will make one table. Suppose my table name will be my table, and then I will clear this all data. I have to make a name address as, so I will simply write name varchar, suppose length of name is 50 and then age integer and then address, it is also varchar, suppose 50, and then another I have country hobbies, so I will write countries, country, country, bear care, suppose 30, and then I have hobbies, and it is also suppose var char suppose 25 and then 6 is also var char suppose 10 and then I have comment in percentage. So I will simply write comment var char suppose 5000 and then I will make one percentage here. So percentage percentage it should be int. So I will press shift enter here. Now I will execute this also. Okay, my table successfully created, and then I can see from here also. I will refresh this page. Python database and my table name is my table. So you can see a name, age, address, country, hobby, sex, comment, percentage. So I will fill this table now and then I will store my data here in this database. I will make some changes here. I will write t1, okay, and then I will write here t2 and then here also t2, and then I will, it should be t2 and it should be t3. So my name is stored in t1, my address is stored in t2, and my age is stored in t3. Now I will make some changes here also. I will make c1 as a combo box and c2 as first check button and c3 as my second check button. Now when I press submit button, I will not display now this message. So I will write some code here. When I click submit button, I will connect this page to database. So I will simply copy this code. I will copy Ctrl C and then I will paste inside my submit button function. So I will paste here Ctrl V. Now all are set. Now I will write one SQL here. SQL equals to L equals to insert into my table names. My table, I have a name, address, age, country, hobbies, sex, comment, and then percentage. And I will pass values, VALUES values. I have to write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 percentage yes. Percentage yes, percentage yes, percentage yes, percentage yes. Now I will copy this line of code, Ctrl C and then Ctrl V, okay. And then name, address, age, country, hobbies. Name, address, age. I have to write address here. So I will press structure and then I will select this age and address and then I will press on change. I will write address here. So address address here and age here. I will change int as var char and var char as int. And age length is 10 and this length is 50 and then I will click on save. Because I have age after address, so I will change the position of address and age. And then I will write value here. So val value equals to, I will get a name first. So my name is stored in t1. You can see here my name is stored in t1 and then address in t2 and age in t3. So I will simply write t1.get and then t2.get and then t3.get. So I will get value from here. t1.get and t2.get and t3.get. Now my country is stored in c1, so I will simply write c1.get. Now to get value of check button means this hobbies, I cannot write like c2.get, c3.get. I have to write some code here, so I will simply write here some comment to get check button 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 value. You can see here I have passed var1 and var2 in this check button. So if I check on this playing, my var1 will be 1, and if I selected this studying, my var2 will be 1. If I will not select this button, means this playing, my var1 will be 0, and if I will not select studying, then my var2 will be 0. So if I select both playing and studying, then my var1 and var2 will be 1, and if I unselect these two, then my var1 and var2 will be 0. So I can simply write if var1 dot get means playing equals to 1, means if I select playing, and also if I select studying equal to 1, then I will store playing and studying in s1 string. So playing and studying, and if I select only playing, so if var1.get equal to 1, I will write playing to s1. If I select only studying, var2.get equal to 1, I will write studying to s1, studying, studying. Else I will assign empty to s1. So if I select both playing and studying, then my var1 and var2 will be 1. So I will assign s1 to playing and studying, and then if I select playing, I will assign s1 as playing, and if I select studying, I will assign s1 as only studying. So now I will write s1 here. In the same way, I will write some code for radio button also. So to get radio button value, so my radio button is stored in var. You can see here I have passed var here, this var. So if I select male, my var will have value 1, and if I select female, my var will have value 2, and if I select other, my var will have value 3, because I have assigned value equals to 1, value equals to 2, and value equals to 3. So I can simply write if var.get equal to 1, means if I select male, I can simply write s2 equals to male. If I select sex as female, then I will write female here. If I select other, then I will write s2 equals to other. Else I will assign s2 to empty. Now I will pass s2 here. This is for radio button s2. Now I have completed up to this much. Now I have to extract my value of comment and percentage. So what I am going to do is, I will simply write my comment is stored in txt text. You can see here I have written my comment in scroll text. So my scroll text is stored in txt text. So I can simply write txt.get. But I have to pass some value here. I have to pass one float point value, so 1.0 means from starting to end. Suppose if I write tk.end, only it will print my alt text. So you can see here from 1.0 means from this to the end, so alt text. So it will extract my alt text. Now in the last, I will extract my percentage. So I have written percentage in spin box, in spin. So I will simply write here spin.get, spin spin.get, and then I will write my cursor, cursor.execute. I will pass SQL and value here, val, and then I will write my db.commit. So my code is completed, and then I will print one message here: your data is successfully inserted. Your data is successfully inserted. Okay, now I will press shift enter. If I press submit button now, so submit, your data is successfully inserted. Okay, now I can see from here, so I will refresh this page. Refresh, you can see here, this is empty, this is also empty, a zero, continue name, comment, write some comment, percentage zero. Now I will fill all this text. Now if I write name equals to Isur and address equals to suppose Butol, and then age equals to 23, and then country Nepal, and hobbies playing and studying, and then sex male, and then comment, and then I will increase my percentage, suppose 10 or okay for 15, and then I will press submit. Your data is successfully inserted. I will close this and I will refresh this page. You can see here, name is your address Butol, age 23, country Nepal, hobbies playing and studying, sex male, comment guys subscribe this channel, percentage 15. So in this way you can connect your Python to database and you can store any record in database. So guys, this is all about how can you connect your Python to MySQL database. If you like this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. So guys, see you in the next video. Thank you.